Thank you, Pete, for doing this. I also want to take a moment to thank the town of New Paltz that we have this community center, relatively new. Just here at 5 o'clock, picking my daughter up for dance class. I'm back here at 7 to do this, and I think it's was a long time coming, but I'm grateful that it's here now. And also thank you for understanding that Jared can be here, and I'll do my best to fill his shoes. The basic question here is, do we have fundamental structural issues with our government in New York State? And I think those of us sitting up here are in agreement that the answer to the question is yes. So, is it broken? Yes. Then we must ask, well, how do we fix it? One venue for remedy is a constitutional convention. As mentioned, we're not due to go up for a public referendum until 2017. So some of us have been urging that the legislature put it forth now, that we put it up sooner. That's not going to be easy. There's certainly a minority in the legislature that are fighting for this. So I'm very happy that you gentlemen are doing what you're doing. I certainly believe there's palpable evidence of a systemic problem. Both this governor and previous governors have been unable to really do a lot, and our legislature as well. There's been long moments of complete inaction because of leadership difficulties. I also think that the structure of local government in New York State is a pretty salient issue for those of us in New Paltz. And that is something that could be addressed and looked at with a constitutional convention. There's certainly a lot of process issues and barriers, but we can learn from history. I think one of you mentioned, you know, and it's been proposed in legislation that one of the reasons opponents don't want to do this is that they say that members of the legislature double dip and they serve as delegates to the convention, and they have their job in the legislature as well. But we could prevent that. There's a lot of things that are being thrown out as barriers that are very easily preventable, and we could do things differently with the next constitutional convention. I certainly hope that we can get there sooner than 2017, but there's certainly a lot of preparation that we can do along the way. If we aren't able to get it done before then. We certainly need a significant amount of political mobilization. We need some strong leadership behind this issue. And as has been stated, we need a coalition effort, and it needs to be a bipartisan effort. Jerry has written some essays with former Governor Mario Cuomo. They're out on the desk. You can check those out that are arguing for a constitutional convention. In addition to some of the things that you said that can change, just to throw some of the things that they stated we could change if we got to a constitutional convention would be the end of the three men in a room and the return to effective, informed, shared governance. We could look at how we're doing legislative districting, campaign financing, how we run elections, budgeting, filling vacancies in high office, which I know is always your lead line on the press release. Ethics provisions, our court system, merit selection and retention of judges, looking again, as I mentioned before, our system of local government. So all these are incredibly salient issues and things that we could address with a constitutional convention, and I think they're very compelling, and actually public opinion polls already show that people are behind having this convention. So I end with that and would also remind everyone that the product of a constitutional convention needs to be approved by popular vote. So opponents have said, well, what if we lose this? There's a lot of fear about what would happen if we did this. Well, we have to remember that the people have to vote on it, and they have to agree with the product. So whatever these delegates do, they have to keep that in mind. They can't have something that's going to fail. And we need to do a lot of preparation to figure out how we can get to a point so something can be, first we can get to a constitutional convention, and then there can be a product that the people can believe in.